Servus und hallo, welcome to this new video. First of all, I'm sorry about the noise. There's an ender right there printing boron parts. I had to borrow the ender of my friend because none of my other filament-based printers are working. So today I will show you how to remove a failed print and what to do when you get a failed print, which is fairly simple actually. You just need to watch out for some things. So I was printing something on my Master Pro and the build plate looks like this. I've got a flex plate installed from Wamban, but that's not the problem. Sometimes there's nothing on the supports and sometimes there is something but it looks trash. Let it drip, put it to the side. Now the vat looks like this. I've already drained my resin. I just used the basic kitchen funnel and put the bed in like this. So it drains out. At regular intervals you should use a paint strainer or a paint filter that looks like this to get out any debris that is in there. But we want to get this printing again, and for that we should remove the things that are left in the vat. What I typically do is I have, and I would advise get the same, I have a spray bottle, it doesn't have to be a pink one, there's IPA in it, 99%. 99.9%. It doesn't have to be that, and you can use denatured alcohol. This is just what I can get in a big container like this. This is 10 liters, I think, but supply in your varying countries may differ. It's just in Germany, this is the easiest. You can buy it directly from Amazon or from a local chemical supplier. What I start with is I clean backside with IPA. Just use a paper towel. Usually there is no resin on here, but just in case, I spray it once and then wipe this side. Now I know this is clean. There's some resin here around the pour spout and you clean that off as well. Now you can grab both sides because you know they are cleaned. And then I clean all the top part and everything else is touched with or by resin anyways, so I don't bother with that. Now you have to verify that you have clean gloves. Of course you would use natural gloves. You can spray your hand and wash your hand with the IPA to ensure it is free of resin, because you don't want resin on the underside. And now what you do, like, I'm right-handed, so I just take this in the left hand and I use my finger to slightly push the FEP towards the camera. And then I can lift up the corner and free the failed print. And this is what you do with everything. You go to the corner, you lift it with your finger, and then you get it free. Getting it free is the most important thing, because what you can now do is take your plastic spatula and carefully and then you can take it out. Before I install the vat again, I wanted to show you something. As you can see, this has quite a matte finish, and this is actually a phone protector that allows me to have a failsafe in case you don't clean everything out properly and resin leaks on your screen. But when you have that protector in place, you can peel the protector off and get a new protector and put it on again. I just had that with my Mars and it saved me a lot of headache. I still have a replacement screen, but it is better to have a failsafe in place, because changing out screens on the regular can get expensive really quickly. So now all that's left to do is, with our clean vat, is to install it again. And after we've cleaned or cleared the build plate, we could start another print. And that's what I'm going to do right now. But before that, the topic of when to clean out your vat comes up quite a lot with beginners. What I often see is, then when they have a failed print, they pour the resin out and then clean the vat with IPA. Not just the thing that I just did, but also with IPA. But you don't have to do that if you plan on using that resin, because it is unnecessary and puts strain on the FEP, because the FEP gets cloudy when alcohol is applied on it. You don't have to clean out your vat unless you change resins. Not necessarily resin color, but resins. Like when I go from my standard resin option to premium, I usually clean it out or squeegee it out, because when my customer pays for premium, they will get premium. Most of the times, if you are in a warm environment, just pouring it out and letting it drip for half an hour or an hour is enough to get everything out. You don't have to clean it with IPA unless you want it very, 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 very clean. And that's what I usually do when I like print with transparent resins. Then it's important, but everything else, it's kind of unnecessary and puts unnecessary strain on the material. Also, a quick tip. Today is the 10th of November and we are located in the middle of Germany. That means it is 6 degrees outside and I'm in an uninsulated basement. What does that mean? Gets quite cold here. What is the cold effect? The viscosity of a liquid. Not much with water, but with anything else. If you've toyed with fat or oils, you know that if the material is colder, it flows less. Like it has. Doesn't flow that easily. And that's why you can, and it's actually recommended, I will soon build an enclosure for my resin printers, but if you don't have that or don't want to do that, you can heat up your resin bottle in a tub of warm water. The thing is, these resins, like, they are not this Eligo resin, and it's not engineering resin. The engineering resins tend to be, want to be printed at a higher temperature, but these ones only have, like, essentially room temperature 20 to 25 degrees. I don't know who wants to live in a room that's 25 degrees, but you get the point. I have adjusted everything so I can, so it should be able to print. You may notice that the color is slightly off. That's because I'm using a colorant. It's just alcohol ink. The good thing is with the flex plates is that you can take them off. And to get rid of the failed prints, you can just flex it. And get everything off. I like to press home and then go to the print menu because my Master Pro is very slow on the Z. And of course you need a USB stick. This is a very, this is the like slim form factor of a USB stick, which I would recommend for Master Pro. If you're working in this space, it is easy to hit the stick and then break the port. And there you have it, an easy what to do after a failed print. If you're interested, and you may know, I run an eBay shop and soon I will have an NFAP style type of plastic in my eBay shop. If you're from the EU, you can purchase it from the eBay shop that is linked in the description. Sorry, America and UK. Shipping to the UK is a nightmare. After they left the EU, and I don't know why they did that, but politics. So I hope you found this video useful. Give me a like if you did, and subscribe to not miss any more videos that I upload. It is usually one a week. I will see you in the next video. I hope you print something and that you have no print failures. Tschüss und auf Wiedersehen.